So, the Apostle Paul in Romans, he talks about a race, right? He talks about a race that if you steadfast and keep going or whatever, blah blah blah, and at the end or whatever, you will be saved. Well, guess what? That is contrary to what how to gain eternal life. That's what Paul says, but I'll tell you what Jesus Christ, God in the human flesh, says. Jesus says in John chapter 10, verse 28, I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. And then Jesus goes on and mentions saying, I give them everlasting life, and all who believe, nobody can snatch them out of my Father's hand. Nothing, nobody, you can't, demons can't, Satan can't, sins can't. So once you believe in Jesus Christ for salvation, it's yours, and you can never lose it, reject it, throw it away, forfeit it, any of those things. Those are all leadings from Satan saying that you can lose your salvation or forfeit it or reject it. Well, you can reject salvation. Rejecting salvation is just means that you never placed your faith in Jesus Christ for the only way to get saved. But after you have done that and he saved you, you don't have to wait until the end of your life and then you'll be saved. You're saved right there and then. It says it very clearly. It states in Romans chapter 10, verse 10 verse, it's been a while since I've read that Romans thing. Romans 10:9. For if we confess with our mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe it in your heart that God rose him from the dead, you shall be saved. You have to believe it. You have to confess Jesus Christ with your mouth that he is Lord and the only way to salvation. And you have to believe it with all your heart in your heart that he is the only way to heaven to get saved. The only way. And that he died on the cross for your sins and that God his Father rose him again on the third day. And then you have to acknowledge him or receive him or accept him as your Lord and Savior into your life. And if you do all of those with believing 100%, no doubt whatsoever, you have to believe it with everything you have. You have to believe it 100%. Then you will be saved. He will save you, and there is nothing that you can do to ever lose salvation. The Hebrews 10:26 crap is not saying to a Christian that they can lose their salvation. It's talking about other sacrifices to get saved. There's only one sacrifice, Jesus Christ on the cross. Hebrews chapter 10:26 verse states, if we go on deliberately or willfully sinning after coming to know the knowledge of the truth, there's no sacrifices left but a fearful judgment of, or fearful expectation of God's judgment. That's not talking about Jesus as the sacrifice. It's talking about other sacrifices. If you're placing human sacrifices, animal sacrifices, in front of or above Jesus Christ's sacrifice for your sins, then that's what that means. It's not saying if you sin and sin and sin to a certain degree and a certain limit that Jesus Christ's sacrifice doesn't work, forgive your sins anymore, because he is eternal and Jesus Christ is his forgiveness is everlasting as he is everlasting. So there's no degree, there's no limitation, there's no limit of sin that you can sin in order for him to never forgive you anymore. So that's, it doesn't, Hebrews 10:26 doesn't mean that. I used to think that for years and it scared the crap out of me because that's, I've done that before. After getting saved, I went into unrepentant, full, knowledgeable, willful, deliberate, habitual sin for like 3 years after getting saved, getting drunk, overdosing on medications, clonazepams, Benadryl, all for recreational use, And if that's what that meant, then I would be so screwed. But what Paul says is finish the race, and then at the end you will be saved. That's not contrary to what there. That's contrary to what the Bible teaches about salvation. Salvation doesn't come at the end of somebody's lifetime. It comes when you first believe in Jesus' sacrifice. You are saved and sealed for the day of redemption. So that's the Holy. Once you get saved, the Holy Spirit comes into your heart. You're flooded with full knowledge of God, Satan, demons, Jesus, angels, heaven, hell, eternity. 100% sure that everything in the spiritual world is real. Demons, Satan, angels, God, Jesus, heaven, hell. All that. The Holy Spirit leads you into all truth. That's what it says in the Bible. The Holy Spirit guides you and leads you in all truth. Listen to Jesus Christ, people. Don't listen to Paul in the Bible. Listen to what Jesus says. I did, and I got saved. I didn't do what Paul says. If you don't get saved by what the Bible says, but decide to go on Paul's words, living your entire life, and that at the end of your life you'll be saved, then you're going to spend eternity in hell because you never received the only way to get saved in the first place. So, because Paul never says anything about that you have to get saved by Jesus Christ. That's the error right there. If you don't hear about salvation is only in Jesus, but read Paul's words, Paul will say you have to fight the good fight, and then at the end of the race or whatever, he's talking about a race or something, then you'll be saved without ever placing your faith in Jesus' sacrifice, believing that he died on the cross for your sins. So there's a lot of people that say Paul was a false apostle. You know, there's apostle and apostasy. Apostasy is actually means somebody who claims to be a Christian, that they got saved and stuff. They got saved, believed in Jesus Christ, when they know for 100% sure that they never actually did. And say that, they go around calling themselves a Christian, but sinning and sinning and sinning. That's a difference than actually believing in Jesus Christ for forgiveness of your sins, getting saved, and then sinning after that. There's a huge difference. If you believe with all your heart that Jesus is the way to salvation, and you get saved right there and then with the Holy Spirit and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then you sin and sin and sin. It's all that's already paid for. He died. Your sins died with him on the cross. So through Jesus Christ and God the Father's eyes, you're perfect. You have no sin whatsoever in you because it's all washed away. God says, I cast your sins from the east to the west, and your sins will be as white as snow and not red as crimson. So there's a lot of verses and stuff talking about sins that indicate that sins, there's no limit of sins that you can actually get to lose your salvation, because there's no way that you can lose salvation. There's Jesus and Father God sees us as only the saved people, perfect beings, sinless. There's no sin in us, just the blood of Christ. I have a video on my channel. Search for it. It's called The Blood of Christ, The Blood of Christ is the liver of our the liver of our souls is the blood of Christ, or something like that. Meaning, I can't remember what I described in that video. It was like over a year ago. You know, your liver, your liver and your physical body filters out toxins and poisons, right? Well, it's like a symbolic thing that I said, the liver of our souls is Christ's blood. Christ's blood filters out sin. So whenever you sin, it's already filtered out in your soul form. It doesn't even stick. It doesn't even come into your soul. So you can still enter heaven because his forgiveness, his blood, has washed you clean of all of your sins. That's, and it purifies you from all unrighteousness. So that's awesome news right there. If you want to be saved 100%, listen to Jesus Christ's words, not Paul's. Jesus Christ's, not the apostle or apostate Paul. Jesus Christ, he's the one who mentions how to get saved. I hope you guys enjoy this video. I know a lot of people here are going to disagree with me, but God is speaking through me, you guys. He's talking through me. He's having me figure out what words and phrases to use in order to make you guys understand the best way that I can. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll talk to you later.